Hey, my name is Marco. I'm a former pro opera singer turned voice actor. Today we're going to be listening to the Lament of Orpheus from Hades. I love this game. I never heard this song in the game. I must have not gotten far enough, but you know, Orpheus definitely has a hard time. He's in love with Euridice, and he has to go down to hell to save her. But the stipulation is, if he wants to save her, he can't turn and look at her. Which this obviously devastates Euridice, and she. What happens? What happens? You know. It's an incredibly sad tale of wanting to give in to your lover and show compassion, but also knowing that you risk to lose it all if you turn and look. And yeah, it's tragic. There's a lot of opera that is based on Orpheus. The aria that comes to mind is "Che faro senza Euridice." There's Orpheus in the Underworld by Offenbach. It's a powerful story, and I think it has survived the test of time because, you know, it's a very human story. And so I'm interested to hear this version of it, especially because, you know, there's so much about this story that it's just, the natural evolution of music. And while I don't think this is going to be classical music, the genre, I do think that it's amazing that we're still being told these stories, even today, and they're still relevant and still important. So let's dive in. We hear I believe it sounds like a lyre. I don't know if it actually is a lyre. L-Y-R-E. You know, humming is so powerful. We've talked about this in other videos, but humming really, you know, sometimes don't need words, you know? Even just that, you hear sadness. You hear lament of Orpheus. You feel a sense of depth of pain and sorrow. So interesting, as a side note, because in voiceover, we're often asked to pitch things down at the end of phrases. Try this today. You know, you point down, but this, everything's going up. And actually, I think find it kind of interesting because Orpheus is going down and his music is going up pitch-wise. And the further down he goes, the higher the pitch goes, maybe. But, you know, I think it actually gives it a much, much more crying, much more sincere, honest sound when we... You know, just point it up like that. And also, it sounds to me like this singer, who's exceptionally good, is not using full voice. There's a lot more of that breathy. No, 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 no. Probably very close to the mic. No, 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 back to me. It's very like, again, we've talked about breath and the power of breath. Releasing, having that breath really builds up that tension and really makes us raw and it makes us emotional. I think is really what is really powerful about this. It feels like he's talking to himself. Don't look back. Do not look back. Don't look back. Don't look back. You know, I can't look back. Amazing. Falsetto. Don't look back. Don't look back. Right up here. It's all head voice. There's no chest in that. There's no, and there's no raising the soft palate. There's no futzing with anything. Don't look back. It's all right from here up. There's no don't look back. It's beautiful. I mean, it's haunting. It's really just amazing to hear this music evolve from Che faro senza Euridice to don't look back. It's the same. What am I going to do without Euridice? I better not turn around. This is what they told me to do. This is amazing. As always, thank you so much. If you want to support the channel, feel free to check out the links in the About section, but there's never any pressure, of course. Feel free to check out the Discord. Yeah, as always, thank you so much, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.